On today's photo moment, we are going to be talking about the Lensbaby Sol 22. This is another little bit of funky deliciousness from our friends at Lensbaby. Good afternoon and welcome to PhotoJoseph's Photo Moment, the first live 3 times a week show, youtube.com/PhotoJoseph every Monday, Wednesday, Friday, usually 9:30 a.m. Pacific. However, on the rare occasion, we do it in the afternoon, like today, 3 o'clock in the afternoon, trying to hit some people on other parts of the world, get some other time zones brought in. And it's working. I see our friend Yurda from the Czech Republic is here for his first time on the stream. So welcome. Thank you. That is awesome. So today we're talking about this little thing called the Lensbaby Sol. Now, a lot of you are familiar with Lensbaby lenses. These guys have been around for quite a while here. And their first lens, their first lens was quite literally a piece of glass with a very springy bellows on it that you twisted and pushed and pulled and bent to make it distort however you wanted. Over the years, they have evolved that lens, advanced that lens, and this is quite an advanced progression of that lens. They also do a bunch of other fun things as well these days. But basically this lens, it allows you to tilt and push it, and it's meant to have some really fuzzy, really distorted edges to it that you can manipulate and lock into place, which is really neat. And this lens has another feature where it has these little blades that cover over the lens to create some funky bokeh. So we're gonna take a close look at all of this. But before I just go into showing this, I actually spent the morning out taking pictures and shooting a little bit of video so that I could show you some of this kind of through the lens out in nature. And well, I did a thing. So but let's take a look at what we created here. So there you have it, just a quick little throw together. Honey, thank you very much for willing to be posing for me this morning. There you go. So this, as you can see, it's kind of a funky lens. You get some really cool swirly bokeh and some really funky edge effects. So let's just take a quicker, closer look at it, and then we'll actually plug it into the camera so you can see through it live and see how it works as I manipulate it. But there's a couple things about it that are really worth looking at on here. First of all, these aperture blades that I mentioned, these slide in front of the lens, and you can position them wherever you want to there, and you can rotate them by sticking your finger inside, trying not to touch the glass, and spinning that around. And I tried to do this while it was shooting video, but then your finger does get in the way, so you can't really do that. But it does apply some really interesting effects. You get that really good streaky bokeh that you saw in some of the shots. To focus, it's just a focusing ring right there, and it's pretty easy to focus, especially with focus peaking turned on. And then here is the actual bendy part of it. So let me unlock this. It's a little bit hard to do when it's not on the camera, so let me do that real quick. I'm going to attach this to the camera body. It'll give me a little bit of a torque here to hold on to it. And you'll see that you can actually bend the lens in just look at it. It's easier to see than it is to explain. So I can twist it. Let me see here. See how this got a little lock on it? Let me unlock that. And now, see, I can actually twist it and turn it in different directions, up and down. But it stays wherever you put it. But let's take a look through it. Let me grab the cable that I just conveniently threw on the floor here. Take a look through the lens, and you can see in real time what it looks like, because it's a lot of fun. And you saw that I shot some video with it too, which I thought was really neat to be able to do that, to get that movement, even when I was focusing through. You saw like the black and white shot as I was focusing through the shot there, and you got that kind of blur moving, which was kind of neat. So, all right, let's see here. Let's go take a look through the lens here. And I didn't really set up a shot to look at here, but let me just do a quick focus. And a little bit darker there. There you go, so you can really see the blur around the edges there. Now I'm going to manipulate it. I'm going to kind of push it to the side. You can see how much the whole shot moves as I twist the lens around. And then I'm going to go in and I'm going to reach in and move those blades in and out of place. You can kind of start to see the shadowing happening on the lens. Okay, that's my finger. I don't know if I can find the shadow. There it is. Find the blade in there. Let's get that completely out of the way. So it looks like that. Let's refocus that a little bit. There we go. Refocus that. So there's the blades out of the way. And then as I move them in, you can start to see some weird shadowing happening throughout the shot. It's affecting the bokeh a little bit. If I make it a little bit out of focus, you'll see some of that more effectively. It's just really interesting. Overall, a very fun effect. So I think it's one of these things that if you've got a little bit of extra budget, it's not an expensive lens, $200. For Micro Four Thirds, it's $200. I didn't actually see, let's see if it's the same for others. Here's the Canon version. Yeah, same, $200. So they're keeping the focal length the same. So you see it's 22 millimeter on Micro Four Thirds, which would be 44 on full frame. Then there's a 45 millimeter Canon, a 45 millimeter Fuji X. Looks like they're all about the same price. And the sizing obviously is going to change a bit depending on the lens. But they've got them for your full lineup there. You got Pentax, Sony, Nikon F mount, Canon EF, and so on. So there you go, $200. You know, not a huge expense. It's definitely not something you're going to use every day, but it is kind of a fun, funky lens. And if you're looking to create something unique and interesting, hey, you could certainly do worse. So there you go. I hope you enjoy that. It was fun to play with. In full disclosure, I have absolutely no idea where this came from. I believe Lensbaby shipped it to me. It showed up in a box unmarked. So I'm like, all right, cool. Thanks, guys. I'll do a little video on it. B&H had sent me one of these for review, and this time I think it just came direct from Lensbaby. So kudos to them, assuming they're the ones who sent it. But yeah, it's a cool little lens. It's a lot of fun to play with, and at $200, you know, not too bad of a price. If you decide to buy one, you know what to do. There's links down below. And just to remind you as well, the way that we do things on this show is we operate on what we call a value for value proposition. What we say here is if you have gained value from the show, we would certainly appreciate it if you put value back into it. If you head to photojoseph.com/support, you'll see lots of different ways that you can do that, including, of all things, you can hire me directly if you've got any kind of a challenge you're working through, photo, video, workflow related, anything you want to talk about. And I used to have just 1 hour blocks, but I've actually put on there now 20 minute blocks. So I know a lot of people have just small questions, the things they want to spend just a few minutes on. So you can actually book a 20 minute block now. So if you go to that photojoseph.com/support, you'll see that. It's a very limited number of hours that I'm kind of allowing each week as office hours, if you will. But if one of those times works for you, then grab it. And if it doesn't, it says on there, reach out and we'll see what we can work out for you. But that's about that. That's it, my friends. That is it for a Monday. I hope you enjoy this. If you have any questions, we are going to jump into the Q&A portion of the show right now. For those of you watching live, that means you get to live chat your question in. I will bring that up on the screen momentarily. And if you're not watching live, then just stick your question in the comments either here or on the Q&A video, and I'll do my best to address them. We'll see you right back in a minute.